We've just received the new support guidelines. We've just received the new support guidelines.
He has problems because he's not a good reader. He has problems because he's not a good reader.
Have you taken the measurements? I think it's about a litre. Have you taken the measurements? I think it's about a litre.
Please inform us when the whole inspection will be carried out. Please inform us when the whole inspection will be carried out. Do you want me to pass you that poll? Do you want me to pass you that poll?
The chief engineer has asked for a new fitter. The chief engineer has asked for a new fitter.
Have you made an appointment with your employer? Have you made an appointment with your employer? He's very experienced. He's spent a lot of time on board. He's very experienced. He's spent a lot of time on board.
Before sealing, all packages must be thoroughly checked. Before sealing, all packages must be thoroughly checked. Have you read this newspaper? It explains the security requirements. Have you read this newspaper? It explains the security requirements.
John, I'm afraid we've got a problem. What cargo did you carry in the holds on your last voyage?
Grain. Why?
Right, well, holds 4 and 5 are still dusty. You need to sweep them out again or we can't load the cotton.
But the holds were swept properly, I made sure.
Yes, but it's not enough. Cotton can spontaneously combust, it catches fire so easily, so the holds must be absolutely dust-free. If you load the cotton now, you'll have a real fire risk, and I can't allow that.
Okay, I'll tell the bosun to clean the holds again more thoroughly.
Good morning, this is BBC Radio 4. In half an hour, we present Play for Today from our Manchester studio. It's a drama set on board an oil rig in the North Sea. John Black heads a distinguished cast of actors, and the play is directed by Tony Farmer.
So, how many crew members are there on board in total?
14, well, 15 now, including you.
And where are the master and chief officer from?
They're both Norwegians, and most of the ratings are Filipino, but the bosun is Ukrainian.
Oh, that's strange, as he told me, he lives in Russia.
Yes, his wife's Russian, so they both live there.
You'll never guess what I saw yesterday.
Don't tell me.
was the whale that had a face like the mast.
No, I saw hundreds of yellow rubber ducks.
What? Are you serious?
Yes. Haven't you heard about them? They broke free from a cargo vessel about 15 years ago and have been floating around the world ever since.
Is that Jacek? Hey, I'm on my mobile. I need your help.
Why? What's up?
My car just died on the third ring road out of town. I think I've run out of oil. Can you come and pick me up?
So, have a look at the EPUB and tell me what you see.
Is that a crack, Ant?
Don't worry, that's just paint. What else do you notice?
Well, I'm not sure. The HIO date hasn't expired yet.
Can you check the battery too?
Oh, I see. It's nearly reached the expiry date. We'll need to change it.
So, have a look at the EPUB and tell me what you see.
Is that a crack, Ant?
Don't worry, that's just paint. What else do you notice?
Well, I'm not sure. The HIO date hasn't expired yet.
Can you check the battery too?
Oh, I see. It's nearly reached the expiry date. We'll need to change it.
Irziana Airlines, how may I help you?
I'd like to make a reservation for the 22nd of August.
Could you give me the city you're leaving from and your destination, please?
I'll be departing from Glasgow and flying to Kaliningrad.
And when do you want to return?
I want to come back on the 25th. So what are the options, please?
Well, the cheapest we have is €495, but that's a fixed flight and no changes are possible. Or if you want a flexible ticket, that'll cost you €700. Do you have a seaman's book?
No, I'm not a seafarer.
That's a shame, because we could have issued you with a marine ticket. That's only €375.
Okay, I think I'd better go for the flexible ticket.
This is Network South Railways. Train departure and arrival times for Newtown today are as follows. 10 o'clock fast train is a non-stop service arriving at Newtown at 13:10. This is followed by the 11 o'clock, which calls at Addington, Baybridge and Waystorm, arriving at Newtown at 14:45. I'm sorry to announce that the 9 a.m. express service to Newtown has been cancelled. This is because the train has developed an electrical fault.
So, make sure you wear your safety goggles when you do that job. By the way, do you know what the most common cause of eye accidents is?
I would guess welding, sir.
Actually, that's the least common.
Well, in that case, it's probably chemicals getting into the eye.
You're getting warmer. That's number two on the list. But the main cause is particles getting into the eyes.
Okay, everyone, can I have your attention? Our vessel is entering a dangerous area where pirate attacks are very common. We must make sure that no unexpected visitors get on board. So I want you to keep a sharp lookout. You must keep all doors locked, especially your cabins, and make sure the water hoses are ready to use. If you see anyone or anything suspicious or different, I want you to report it immediately. If pirates do manage to get on board, please remember that your safety is the most important thing, and don't try to fight them.
And now here's the 7 o'clock news with Jennifer Wayne.
Good evening. Coast Guard helicopters were called out today after a yacht capsized in Coolside Bay. Despite heavy rain and rough seas, the helicopters were able to rescue everyone on board. The Coast Guard stated they had issued a warning to small craft yesterday evening, but the yacht ignored these warnings and set sail. All four people on board were hospitalized and are said to be in a stable condition.
The first expedition to sail around the world was Ferdinand Magellan's in the early 16th century. Although others followed, such as Sir Francis Drake, it soon became clear that one of their main problems was plotting their position at sea. And to do this, they needed to accurately measure time. In the 18th century, John Harrison invented an ocean-going clock that told time accurately, despite the weather and the movement of the sea. And Captain Cook was the first person to use one of these clocks over a long journey.
So, what system operates on this ship?
It's 4 hours on, then 8 hours off. It's a lot safer that way and we're well rested.
So, we have three watches, right?
Yes, we have watches Alpha, Bravo and Charlie.
On my last ship, it was 6 hours on and 6 hours off.
You must have found that incredibly tiring.
Well, believe it or not, I'd actually prefer 4 hours on and 4 hours off if I had the chance.
You are kidding.
Well, I suffer from insomnia and never sleep more than 4 hours in any case. So it suits me, to be honest.
The cook has just cut himself, sir.
Right. How bad is it?
He's bleeding quite a lot, sir. I think he might need some stitches.
I saw him using a blunt knife the other day and told him to get rid of it.
No, it wasn't that knife. It was one of the new ones. It must have slipped into the sink. He didn't notice it was in the water when he was washing up.
So, have you finished yet? You seem to be doing a very thorough job.
Well, we've checked all the cabins, the storerooms and the cargo tanks, but we still have to check the medical stores.
Okay, I'll show you where they are. Please come this way. But I can assure you, you won't find any drugs on my vessel.